For regular videos on ancient cultures and forgotten civilizations, please subscribe.
The primary method that Posnansky used to pin a date of 15,000 BC to the second period at Tiwanaku was astronomical dating, based on changes in the obliquity of the ecliptic, analyzing the alignment of the solar observatory, known as the Callus Ossii, to the precise locations on the horizon of the sunrise during the solstices. The ecliptic is the plane projected by the Earth's orbit around the Sun, more or less the disk in which all of the planets orbit. The obliquity of the ecliptic is the angle between the plane of the Earth's equator and the plane of the ecliptic. As most people know, the Earth's axis is tilted, so that angle today is approximately 23.5 degrees. This tilt in the Earth's equator gives us the seasons as we orbit the Sun. The degree of this tilt is not fixed, however. There is a slight oscillation to it, and its value swings between 22.1 degrees and 24.5 degrees in a cycle that takes around 41,000 years to complete. With careful analysis and due to this change in the obliquity of the ecliptic, the exact location on the horizon of the sunrise changes very gradually over time. The solar observatory of the Callus Ossii was constructed as a marker for the sunrise on the solstices, the longest and shortest days of the year. Posnansky set out to measure the difference in the obliquity of the ecliptic at sunrise on the solstices between his time, around 1930, and when the alignment would have been precisely matched to the construction of the Callus Ossii.
Note here that Uncharted X is going to be using a long-term natural cycle, in this case the Earth's obliquity cycle, a period of 41,000 years, as a way to date the construction of a building. As you might guess, using a method such as this to determine the age of buildings is not common, particularly because it is based on the assumption that the building was constructed with an extremely precise orientation toward certain heavenly bodies, and there's no way to prove that unless the builders told us so.
It turns out that the structure also aligns with the locations for the sunsets on the solstices, I think making it undeniable that the Callus Ossii is absolutely a solar observatory and not just some sort of coincidence, but this discovery would only be made long after Posnansky had passed away.
There is general agreement that the Callus Ossii, like the sunken temple before it, functioned as an observatory. For a viewer standing on the central platform, the outer two pillars would have visually demarcated the setting sun on the two solar solstices. The north pillar indicated the beginning of winter in the southern hemisphere on June 21st, and the south pillar the beginning of summer on September 21st. Every second pillar between them marked a 30-day countdown of setting suns. The central pillar marked the equinoxes.
If we examine this phenomenon with precision instruments, we note a difference of approximately 18 minutes, which represents the change in the obliquity of the ecliptic between that of the period in which Callus Ossii was built and that which it has today. This difference has served as the basis for the calculation of the age of Tiwanaku.
Okay, so this is where the discussion of the Callus Ossii Observatory goes off the rails. The whole idea of measuring with precision instruments is based on the assumption that the construction was made so accurately that there was no discernible error. When Posnansky measured the angles between two suspected solstice points in the complex, from the eastern corner to a partially buried lava observational block, the assumed original position of the gateway of the sun, in the center of the western end of the structure, he noted that it gave an obliquity of the ecliptic not of 23 degrees 27 minutes, as for the year 1930, but 23 degrees 8 minutes 48 seconds. He supposed that the structure was not built with any error, therefore it had to have been built when the obliquity was 23 degrees 8 minutes 48 seconds. According to his calculations, the Callus Ossii was built circa 15,000 BC. But you see, this is the problem with this interpretation. The alignment of the Callus Ossii still works today. I mean, that is how it was noticed in the first place. It just isn't perfect, and it may never have been. So to assume it was perfect, and then to redate it to make it so, is fudging evidence to make it suit your preconceptions.
Posnansky spent years on the site carefully examining the alignment of the Callus Ossii, and also enlisted the help of several astronomers, like Professor Rolf Müller from the German Astronomical Mission, who spent several years on site confirming his results.
Yes, intrigued by Poznanski's findings, the German Astronomical Commission in 1926 sent an expedition to Peru and Bolivia. Esteemed astronomers Hans Ludendorff, Arnold Kohlschutter, Friedrich Becker, and Rolf Müller were among them. They certified that Poznanski's calculations were correct and that the alignment indicated a foundation date of either 15,000 or 9,300 BC, assuming the observational points were correct. Later, Müller rechecked the calculations and gave new dates of either 10,150 BC or 4,050 BC, depending on which alignments were taken. So yes, astronomers verified the alignments, but all they did was check the calculations. They were not in a position to evaluate whether or not the supposed alignments were intended by the builders, or whether the builders would have made perfect alignments in the first place. It's interesting to note that in 1930, there was a movement to replace the Gregorian calendar with another, better one. It never happened, but Poznanski was involved in the conversations, and he proposed using the Tiwanaku calendar, which he claimed to have reconstructed, along with some of his own modifications, as a superior one that the world should adopt. Bolivian elites loved it.
When this date was published by Poznanski and by the astronomers from Europe that accompanied him, it was unsurprisingly met with fairly strong criticism, most of which just dismissed the findings with terms like absurd and with no scientific refutation.
It's not the calculations that are being refuted. It's the premise upon which the calculations were made, namely that the Colossi must have been constructed with extreme precision. This premise was not arrived at scientifically. It was an assumption from the get-go. The calculations mean nothing if they're based on an unsupported premise.